Hello everyone, welcome back to Netcode-Hub channel. So in this video, we're going to talk about how to enable CRUD operations in ASP.NET called Blazor. So you can see that we had a data grid whereby we have the table and we're able to apply paging, sorting, grouping, and sets as well. So how do we add, how do you also delete, how do you read data? That's a CRUD operation. So how do you add it? Let's get going by adding those features. So in our notes here, this is what we have. Now, first of all, in order to add, create, read, update, and delete operations, this is what you're going to do first. So we have to indicate an SF grid. So we have a data source, and we're going to have our toolbar. Okay, so let's copy this, and we're going to add it into our toolbar. So let's copy this, and as you can see from here, let's go to application. And now where we have our index.razor, so here we are having this. So let's first clear this. We don't want to have a search here. So this, now let's add this as toolbar to this. So we're going to add these operations. Okay, so let's see. So after adding this, we are adding a list of string. That is a add, edit, update, delete, and cancel. Now, these names are the keys. So these are the keys that are going to be used to implement. So you make sure you apply these keys as well, right, as I've done. You add it as a toolbar to your SF grid. You know we have a data source already. These are the columns. Okay. Aside from that, you have to set a primary key. So let's take this off. So let's use an ID. This ID as a primary key. So let's use S. Primary key, let's set this to true. So this is primary key, and we set this to true. So after setting that, the next thing to do here is what? We have to enable our grid edit settings. So allow editing, allow adding, and allow deleting. So let's copy this, and you have to actually enable this. So in here, let's enable this. So let's put it here. So grid editing settings, or grid edit settings. So we have allow adding, true, allow editing, true, allow deleting, also what, true. What's the next thing to do? Well, let's run application now and see what we have now. So let's save this. And now let's run application. So click on this, or click on debug, and click on the start debugging. So let's start and see. All right, so our page is now loaded, and you can see we have those CRUD operations on top. So add, edit, update, and update, right, and delete. So let's see. So how do we add? You can just double click on this. Let's see if it's gonna work. So you have double click to get it added. So this is to edit. So you see we have an update here. Now, if you want to add, double click on these two, update. Okay, so change the name, and then you have to update it, and it is done. So let's update it as well. So L, let's add the L, hit on the enter key, and it is also done. Now, if you check here, you can see we can add, we can edit. So if you want to edit this, just click on this, and now edit. So you're going to have all this edited. This is a primary key, that's why you can't edit here. Okay, so because we have all these being edited. Now I can click on add, and you're going to add a new item to this. Okay, so let's add an item here, and that's going to be test last name. Let's test name, and now email is test@gmail.com. So now let's add this. Now we see it has been added. So we have ID as 0. Now let's add one more. So we still have a problem here, but our focus here is to add. So we are able to add this. Okay, we are able to add this data. Let's still add one more. So here you can pass in the ID. Now here, the name field is required, so we have to actually, let's cancel that. Now with this, let's delete this. So this deleted. Now let's add. So instead of passing the ID here, you can pass an ID as 7. And you can now pass in test So test @gmail.com. And now let's see. So let's use this at. Let's click on. So this is what updated. Hit the enter key and we have it inserted. Okay, so that is how to actually enable the CRUD operation. So you can see we're able to add that, and this is the toolbar on top, and now we are good to go. I believe this is very simple, so let's go through again. So just have to apply the toolbar. So after applying the toolbar, just apply the grid settings inside the SF grid component, allow editing, allow this deleting to true. So if you take off this, it means you can't delete. If you take off or you set this to false, any of this to false, it means that action can't be performed over there. And you can see we have this as over here as displayed nicely on top as a toolbar on the SF grid or the data grid. That is it for this video. So thank you guys for watching. I hope this is clear and it's very easy to also apply. I'll meet you up in the next video.